In this episode of Finno-Greek Machining, we are not going to make the outer gear. Well, there is a reason for that. It's quite late in the evening and I don't want to wake up my neighbors by grinding with an angle grinder out there. It would be, well, it would be a light show for the New Year's Day, but, well, okay. Instead, we are going to do some lubrication holes for the gears. I will show you soon what happened with the gears after running them one day. And then we will do some mass production. We are going to make 8mm pins, 36 of them actually. So, let's first see what happened to the gears after running them for a while. Well, here is now the base plate for this cycloidic drive, and here are the gears which I have been running in this constellation for one full day, 24 hours actually. And the result, well, you might see that I have done some beautification here. I have filed this key to a suitable thing. Then I also added a tapered pin here going through the shaft so that it locks this on place. The key, it stays there, doesn't come out. So, how about the gears? How are they now? They were really tight when I first started this thing, and now, wow, they go there like that. And the next one. That's actually a very good result. Yeah. They are there. There is very little play in them. Very little, actually. And, well, it certainly did what I expected. It has been worn in. Okay. So, to prevent this from wearing out so soon, because now the lubrication here, I have been thinking a lot about the lubrication of these things. And this is the pins here, the three pins here, are just ordinary mild steel pins. They are thick, but they are still ordinary mild steel. And so are these gears. So this means that there is a real danger of galling here on these shafts. So lubrication must be taken very good care of. And at the moment when the gear is there, this is lubricated by grease. So there is no way the grease can enter this hole. This hole here, it, well, so I have been thinking what to do with this, and I have come into one solution which I now will, it will be a proof of concept. let's see, the next thing I will show you is in the drill press. Now the general idea here is that I would like to put a hole here in the bottom of one of these gear teeth, there in the very bottom. So then when the gear rotates, it sort of pushes the grease into the shaft. Well, that's the idea anyway. I don't know whether it really does that. Well, it should do it. So, the correct position for putting this is on the thin side of this non-concentric thing. So, then there will be a small gap in this side when this is pushing the thing around. So, therefore, the hole should be in such a place like this, so that it there is a gap for the grease to go into. If it's totally blocked, there is no, and there is no gap. Well, and you know, this is not exact science, the place of this hole. The only thing is that it should be, well, I need to locate it somewhere in between, like there. And then about half the way of the gear it is. Well, that's about in the middle. Oh yeah. And there is a real danger of breaking this drill. It's a 1.5 millimeter drill. I will be running it really fast. Or it should be run really fast. So, let's see now. And it's like this. I don't know what the revolutions really are, but let's see how this goes. I have not tried this yet. Yeah. Goes like into a butter. Wow. Yeah, true. Wow. I thought that this might be very... oh well. We have a hole there now. Let's see if I can... Well, yeah, there is a hole. Hole in the gear. I need to clean this up. Let's take the next patient. Man, this... Well, these copper plates are just protecting my gears so that I don't mark them when I do this. Okay. And now align the drill again. It should be quite precise. Okay. Yeah. There we go. And we are through. Okay, and the last one. This was already done, right? Yeah. That's the one. Oh yeah, a little bit aside. Well, actually how I align this there is that when when I push it gently down, I can see when this drill bends. And then I know which direction the table should be moved. So now it looks like it doesn't bend at all. So we are in the middle of the gear. So... Next step, clean the gears and then do a proof of concept. Oh. Here is now our gears with a hole in them. And let's see now. I just run a reamer through there and then wiped clean everything. So there are no metal flakes anywhere at the moment. And no grease either. Now how to make sure that it does what I suspect it to do. I don't put grease into there directly. I don't want to do that because I want to see if it comes through into there when I rotate this. So I have this vaccination thing and then I can squeeze. Oh, it's greasy. So I have now this clean vaccination thing. It had a lot of grease on top of it. So now when I squeeze here, you can see there comes some grease out from there. So I put the grease in between there. Fill every gap there. This is a very nice thing to have in an injection thing, this grease. It's easy to put your grease exactly where you want, like this. Yeah. Oh, sorry about that. A little bit of extra noise for you. So, now this is ready for rotation, and well, we didn't have any grease on the shafts, so now it will be seen whether it squirts out from there. It should. I don't know what happens now. Well, at least we have some grease there, so I cannot see anything immediately coming out from there. Makes a funny sound, though. But this will be seen after a while, I believe. It takes some time. I should see some grease coming out from here on the rim, on each of them, after a while. So I leave it running like this. Well, the grease tends to come out from there. In the final setup it won't come out like this, because there is a plate on top of it which blocks the grease. So well, let's see whether it pumps the grease there as I let it run for some while, and then I will inspect whether the grease has penetrated all the way through. Well, while the experiment, the lubrication experiment is running there, let's talk about this, 8mm pin factor. So, first of all, I will be using this 5C collet, and it's a 10mm, there is this 10mm hot rolled, cold rolled steel. It's a mild steel and it's going all the way through there. And there we have this, there is a lot of hangout here, like this. So therefore I have this redneck spindle here. It's just a rag rolled around and stuffed into there. It works. So my intention here is to make everything repeatable, so that it's easy for me to, once I get everything set up, then I just repeat the thing 36 times. So I'm going to use this tool here for facing, and this one for turning the outer diameter, and this one for parting off the piece. Then I'm going to use this carriage stop. I set it so that when I cut it off, it will always become 18 millimeters long. And how I guarantee that one is the final piece of the puzzle. It's this one, which is then used as a stop here. Well, I will adjust everything now. Well, so let's set up this factory. So, first let's put the lathe on. And let's see that this is tight. It is. I mean the collet. We should have there. First I face it. Just face it. Because when I set this up, I assume that it is like faced. Okay. This time I cannot, and I'm running this at 600 RPM. Not faster because of the whip size turn back. I should run this faster actually. Okay. Well, that's the starting point for every pin. It's it should be faced like this. Okay. But of course the facing occurs, let's see when it occurs. And now this, I should set this up in a way that when I put this parting tool there, I will end up having 18 millimeter long piece of stuff. And it it's max 18, so 17.5 millimeters is absolutely fine. So let's put this away for a while. So now I will just by eye inspect this. I will set the brake a little bit, not tight, but so that it gives some resistance for me. Okay, now. I'll move it until this drops. Now it dropped, and it's 17.7. Let's see. Let's put it there like that, and then measure it really. Of course, I should be using here like that mic, but well, the accuracy in this case, this should be enough. Well, it's 17. It's a hair under 18 millimeters now. So now I lock my carriage stop here. So that is the place where I cut it. And then also, oh, where did it go? Then I also want to set this up now. Now it's there. Yeah. We have a stop there, and well, is it too tight, maybe? I just want it to touch there. Well, the experiment is running there. It will be interesting. So, this is now set up. So, our next thing. So, I have now set up the correct length for this workpiece. Now, the diameter. And we should turn this down. Let's see first. Oh, man. Yeah. This is interesting if we have... Let's see about this. I draw a line here first, like that. And then I would like to see whether the parting tool is going to the correct place. Yeah, good. It's parting right, yeah, in a very good place. So I can run this against the stop. Good. Do I have a room? Man, I don't have the room. We need to move this backwards quite a bit. Like there, at least. Let's see now. There is the one. Okay. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I could probably. This should be now. Let's see how this works. And the surface, well, it's not really bad. It's actually quite good. So let's see now. Let's mic it. It should be around 9 millimeters. Oh, well, around here. Well, it's 500ths under. So 500ths under. Okay. Now I adjust this wheel here in a way that 500ths under, so it will be at that place. Well, maybe I should show you how I did this. This is a little bit different. That was my file. Let's see if I can show this to you. Okay, there you are. That's the dial. Can we zoom in a little bit? Okay, now you can see it actually. So, because it's now, it is, let's assume that this is our goal. We need to go, actually, the zero is our goal. Sorry. Zero is our goal, and we need to go 95 hundredths of a millimeter. So I put this simply there. You see the line there? Now it becomes 95 millimeters, hundredths of a millimeter. When I'm at zero, that's done. Yeah. And now Let's do some turning. Next half a millimeter. It should be quite exactly 8 millimeters. Well, it's a little bit over. I don't like that. I don't like. 5, it's 200ths of a millimeter over. Well, I cannot peel, with this tool I just cannot peel 200ths of a millimeter. So I need to adjust the wheel just the tiniest amount here so that I... It's better to be a little bit under than over. And this feels really good. So, well, and then we part it. And now I don't move the setup, I lock the carriage. I do lock it. And then I change the tool, the parting tool. Well, this is really nice. It goes exactly where it should go. And then we, of course, this will drop somewhere, that workpiece, but yeah. Let's see, I think we can run this with the same speed. This is so small. This is a little bit... Oh no! It's already loose. Wow! Oh, it's hot! It's hot. It's really hot. Ah, this can actually break your tool. Well, that's the first one. With a great nibble. But we will deal with those later on. Because we need to... Well, that was the first one. Okay. Well, and our experiment is evolving here. Looks like if we look what has happened here, this one seems to be pushing the grease through. This one I can see some faint marks that it's already coming through from there. And in this one there is some grease on the inside. So I let it run for a while, but I think it lubricates now these pins properly. Yeah. And this is really like quite heavy grease, so it will take some force to put into there. So it works better than I expected. I was waiting, because this is turning really slowly at the moment. So I expected it to take hours before you can see oil or grease, but now you can see it already there. Especially this one here is really noticeable. Okay, now, well, I have learned something here. So, cutting it in 0.5 millimeter, half a millimeter cuts, that's actually too little for this plate. 1 millimeter cuts are much better. They produce a better surface finish and also more consistent diameter. Well, what do you know? Well, this type of insert is, it's a little bit bigger. So, and it goes faster. The only, drawback is that it produces two chips. One for each pass, a very long string. Well, this one break off. Yeah. Well, maybe 10 chips. Then, well, let's see. measure this one. I already also noticed that sometimes this tends to wander. Well, now it's 0.02 millimeter undersized, which is perfect. Like that. It's perfect. This is actually what I want. And well, now I also learned that you shouldn't face it, because you break your tool when you do the facing. It just doesn't work that way. So now, and cutting this is really easy. This is the easiest part of them all. It's cut, and you can pick it up from there like that. And then I also sometimes make a quality control here, just check the length, and this is 17.5 millimeters, which is perfect. So at the moment, I have 14 of those. And then this end remove with the cutting tool, parting tool, first remove most of the nibble there. And what I have noticed, it's no use in facing this. It's enough that you just file it flat. It's the surface is there, and then you just put some more from here like that, and well, restart the circulation. Let's take this setup apart. Start with this one. And then we have this. Well, so the plan is to put them into this collet and then get rid of this nibble. Let's see if I can. Okay, now, and we are also going to use quite a lot more speed here. I will And now I need to collect some tools here. Let's see about the speed. Yeah. So the file I was using is a little bit ineffective in this case. I will use my... This is a Nicholson Handy file. And it has a coarse side, which... let's see how fast this goes. It goes really fast. Oh yeah. And then it has the other side, which is a single cut. Okay. Now... Well, we still have a nibble there. Okay, now it's gone. And then I will just do it like this. That's one. And then we take some... something like this, and we polish this side. Just like that. And this is the reason for this cover. And now this side of the thing is ready. So I should be able to turn it around. This is already quite good, actually. There you are. So to say, rinse and repeat a few times this one. Oh yeah. Let's measure it because this actually makes it smaller. This is 1/100 under exactly. Oh. 300, so this is this has a taper. I know not every of them has a taper, but yeah, so this is the end product. Nothing fancy about this, just thing like this, and we need 36 of these, so 35 more. Well, here we have 36 pins, which all are, well, they are all over 7.95 millimeters, and they are all under 8 millimeters. So, well, I'm satisfied with that one. Then we had three couples here. which were, well, not so successful. They are almost 0.2 millimeters undersized, so that's way too bad. So, well, now these will be used the next time. So, well, what has happened to the lubrication experiment there? Let's see. Okay, so here is the lubrication experiment, and I can tell you right away that this one, the grease has pushed it all the way through. Good. That one too, there is some grease on the round, and this one as well. So, well, I would call this a success. Ah, they are. Yeah, So yeah, I can see that it's there is grease everywhere in my fingers now as well. So this is a success, actually. So well, have to clean it up. Well, that about concludes this episode of Finno-Ugric Machining. Well, our lubrication experiment went actually better than I expected. It does the lubrication. Good. And then those 36 identical pins, yeah, they're I could have purchased material which is exactly 8 millimeters in diameter and then just made pieces out of that. But what's the fun with that? Okay, well, in the next episode of Finno-Ugric Machining we might be doing the outer gear, which, well, those pins go into there. There will be places for those, and then the outer on the outside there will be a gear. And well, but as always, this will be in the next episode of Finno-Ugric Machining. Till then, bye.